thank you for the invitation. And thank you to all the Scandinavians here. In Scandinavia, there's an appreciation for simplicity and elegance and efficiency. You see it in your design, in your architecture, and in your engineering. I was sitting here in the audience this morning. I noticed this light box here. I don't know if anyone else looks at this sort of thing, but there's white light behind here coming through a filter producing color, and that's an emissive display, and yet the color's matched. That sort of thing's hard to do. I don't know if that's lucky or if someone actually took the time to match the color and make it look good. But those small things add up. So we have more than enough things to keep us up as video engineers. And in fact, this morning's sessions and the remainder of the afternoon are about all the problems we have. But I want to introduce one that I certainly never looked at before, but over this last year, I have started looking at it, and that is the privacy side of OTT streaming. So let's examine a typical session. I'm a client, I make a request to OTT.com. The first thing I have to do is make a request to a DNS resolver. It's probably run by the ISP. It might talk to a number of other name servers, but it's going to come back with an answer. That client is then going to make a request to the edge server at the CDN. The CDN will relay that down and make a request down to the origin. And when it does, it relays through various headers the actual client IP address. So the CDN, the origin, and in fact the ISP, everything colored in yellow, now know that this client IP visited OTT.com. Okay, who cares? Like, is that a big invasion of privacy? Well, maybe to OTT.com it isn't, but if you happen to go to one of these sites, I picked these sites because every one of them contravenes federally protected discrimination rules in the United States and probably in Europe as well. So what happens is your DNS records, your IP address, and your hosts can be seen by your network provider. They're seen by the CDN that relays your information. And we can, various entities, certainly not a CDN, but we can determine identity and location and your interests over time. And I think as individuals, our interests are certainly private to us. So what can we do technically to try to introduce some level of privacy? This is called ODoH, Oblivious DNS over HTTPS. And it works in a pretty cool way. So I have a client, okay, that wants to make a DNS lookup. What it does, there's the client sitting over there, there's a target that's actually going to do the lookup. It knows what the public key of that target is. So it encrypts what it wants to look up, and it sends an opaque package over HTTPS to a proxy server that's sitting in the way. That proxy relays it over to the target. The target can decrypt it because it has the other side of that key, right? And it says, oh, this client wants to know what OTT.com is. So it goes to the DNS resolver, it gets V4, V6 records back, and then it knows the other side of the key. It has the public key for the client. So it encrypts it, and the data moves back all the way to the client, and the client can then get the record. What's interesting about this is that the client knows its own IP address, the proxy knows the IP address of the client, but that proxy doesn't know what website it was going to. And conversely, the proxy sees client IP, but not the query and not the response. The target, which is over here, it sees the query and the response, but it doesn't see the client IP. So we've separated the two. And this is true as long as the proxy and the target are not colluding with each other, which they're not for implementations of Oblivious DNS over HTTPS. So that's good for the DNS side of it, right? But can we do something similar to protect all web traffic, including streaming media traffic? It turns out we can. So let's look at a typical example. I have a client connecting over HTTPS to a CDN, which is then relaying it over to an origin. We can replace that single connection with a set of double proxies now, and we typically call them proxy A and proxy B. And between the client and proxy A and proxy A and proxy B, we're going to use a quick connection. And in this quick connection, we're going to tunnel. Just like we tunneled over with DNS, we're going to tunnel our actual request from the client through to proxy B. So the final connection will be over HTTPS as if the client was connecting directly. And we call this complicated thing multiplexed application substrate over quick encryption, or MASQUE. MASQUE is an IETF standard that's been in existence for quite a while. So this double proxy solution is actually Apple's private relay. It's in deployment right now. Some of you may be running it on your laptops. Proxy A is always run by Apple, even though it's hosted on different providers. Proxy B is run by three different companies or hosted by it, Akamai, Fastly, and Cloudflare. And obviously, as before, there cannot be collusion between the Proxy B providers and the Proxy A providers. So we have legal agreements that we cannot share logs or in any way collude in the implementation of this double proxy scheme. Now, your next question may be, well, how do I, as an origin provider, tell if a connection is coming at me from private relay? So there's a number of ways to do it. Firstly, Apple publishes a list of IP ranges, and there's V4 and V6 addresses, and they're published publicly over here. 207,000 entries when I checked last week. And in Sweden, there's 2,807, of which I list the first here. So you can go and see exactly where these relay points are emanating. These are Proxy B relay points, the ones that you will see in your origin. And here's some links just on homework. Apple speaking about their own solution and some blogs from both Akamai and Cloudflare about the proxies. So I think it's an opportunity. It's not a detrimental effect today for streaming media, but it's certainly something as engineers we need to take seriously to manage and to extract the most performance from. With that, I thank you very much for your time. Thank you.